Oh no, he's back. The man who scared Christina Aguilera.
Like, no, you didn't just say that, you little bitch.
The guy who badmouths one of the world's most beloved rappers.
Will Smith.
For the next half hour, Eminem speaks, you listen.
So I say things just to get a rise out of critics and just to get a rise out of people and to make them
annoy the world.
Yeah, exactly.
Fat with big hits, wicked wit, and more withering insults than have ever before been packed into a single piece of product, Eminem's Marshall Mathers LP, executive produced by Dr. Dre, takes aim at some of the glossiest names in mainstream pop music and takes no prisoners.
Christina Aguilera better switch me chairs so I can sit next to Carson Daly and Fred Durst and hear him argue over who she gave to first.
Well, what about poor little Christina Aguilera? This oral sex reference, she said not only it's disgusting, but not true.
Oh, it probably wasn't, but this is the thing. I met her before, and I had respect for her, too.
What happened?
Where did it go wrong? What happened was when she had her little What a Girl Wants special.
It's time you got on the inside.
I'm watching her little special or whatever, and I'm watching her with her little friends, and she's giggling. And she picked one of my videos.
So I picked Eminem, My Name Is, because whenever this video came out, I think a lot of people woke up and was like, and were really taken aback.
And I was like, that's cool that she picked my video. She heard a rumor that I was married and then said, yeah, he's cute, but isn't he married though?
I heard he's married now.
Eminem?
Uh-huh. Yeah, totally. The girl that he talks about killing on his record, actually.
And I was like, no, you didn't just say that, you little bitch. And then she said, yeah, and you know, doesn't he have a song about killing his baby's mother?
Girls out there, you've got to pull the plug on situations like that. I mean, don't let a guy disrespect you.
And I always tell my friends, if you're against domestic, you know, I'm so against domestic violence, and if you're in an abusive relationship, and I was like, why did she just pick my video? If she's picking it apart, I would rather have had her say nothing about me. She heard a rumor. She didn't know if I was married or not. She just heard a rumor and then put me on blast. But I figured, well, fuck it. Since she did that, you know what I'm saying? All right, okay, I'm married. Okay, whatever, that's cool. But, you know, you said something about me. So I'm gonna voice some rumors that I heard about you.
For whatever reason, he has such animosity, it seems, towards me. I don't know why. But, you know, whatever I said, you know, I don't know what I said to really disturb him, but... you know, whatever I said, I'd say it again, so.
Eminem doesn't hate Christina Aguilera in particular. He clearly can't stand most kinds of smiley teen pop in general. NSYNC, for example, to name just one other hapless act, gets a relentless drubbing.
Ty Backstreet and Ricky Martin. Cause NSYNC's the killing sync. Don't get me started. These brats can't sing and Britney's garbage.
I was trying to listen to the lyrics. Christina got it the worst. I feel bad. Sorry.
Either way, NSYNC, why do they sing? The only one who realizes they stink.
Now, what about NSYNC? Clearly you're not a fan. Anything special about them is especially offensive? I mean,
it's not just NSYNC. I just think the whole pop world is corny. I just think that it's sissy music. And it's just so watered down, man. It's like, you know, how many times can you rhyme tearing me apart?
Tearing up my heart when I'm with you.
Breaking my heart. Love sent from up above. It's ridiculous, it's repetitive, and it gets on my nerves. Every song sounds the same to me.
Bitch, I'ma kill you. You don't wanna fuck with me. Girls need you, ain't nothing but a slut to me.
When you listen to the album, it's like really intensely not poppy and cute.
Yeah.
Is that a conscious decision? You know, I've gotta get away from this, you know, cute blonde guy thing.
It kinda is, because, you know, a lot of times I get grouped up with, you know, the whole TRL crowd.
Number one video on Photo Request Live, according to your votes. Here it is, Eminem.
You know, the Backstreet and Britney Spears, and I have to separate myself from that crowd, because I'm not pop. You know, I can't stand being grouped up in that category neither. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's one of the reasons that I say what I say in my lyrics and make them so left field.
Screaming at night and screaming at mom, scheming to leave. Run away from home and grow to be as evil as me.
I understand that I might make catchy songs.
New kids on the block, sucked a lot of boy-girl groups make me sick. And I can't wait till I catch all you f***ing in public.
You know, they're not watered down. I don't consider it, you know. Like I said, you buy one of my albums, there's gonna be a parental advisory sticker on it every time.
Some people may think there should be a homosexual advisory sticker on this one as well.
You're not a fan of gay people, I gather. Is that a problem you have?
Faggot to me doesn't necessarily mean gay people. Faggot to me just means it's taking away your manhood. You're a sissy. You're a coward. You know what I'm saying? I mean, just like, you know, you might sit around in your living room and say, oh, dude, stop it. You're being a fag, dude. You know what I'm saying? And that doesn't necessarily mean you're being a gay person. It just means you're being a fag, you're being an asshole, whatever. When I started saying faggot on record, I started getting people going, do you have something against gay people? Da, 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 da. And I thought it was funny because I don't.
Hey, fags, the answer's yes. Homophobic? Nah, you're just heterophobic. Staring in my jeans, watching my genitals bulging. That's my motherfucking balls. You better let go of them. They belong in my scrotum. You'll never get hold of them.
As harsh as Eminem's attitude toward gay sensibilities may seem, producer Dr. Dre's is even more coldly dismissive.
Man, I think a lot of people are going to say, too, is that he's very homophobic. He's very, the word faggot crops up a lot, too. I mean, does that bother you at all? Probably not.
No, it really doesn't bother me at all. I don't really care about, you know, those type of people.
I mean, if straight up. If you were gay, would you? Do you think you'd be offended?
I can't even answer that question. That's not a possibility.
I think it's the job of critics, you know, not just to talk about how good the beats are on the record. They are excellent. Mm-hmm. Dre makes great records, period. But what is the content, and what does it say? And what does it say to young people? And what does it say to white, disaffected young males?
Well, do you understand how gay people might feel like this is you're taking shots at them? Especially like the Gianni Versace thing. You
know? Hey, it's me, Versace. Whoops, somebody shot me. And I was just checking the mail. Get it? Checking the mail.
Then I also go on to say, relax, guy. I like gay men, you know. So it's kind of like it's kind of like leaving it up in the air. Like, do I really hate gay people or do I not? You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's up to you to decide.
Hip-hop is for everybody, and it might make some people feel uncomfortable. But as far as Eminem speaking his mind, I mean, that's how you get fans, you know what I'm saying? Some people relate, some people won't.
Even if you don't like his content, you have to admit, if you understand hip-hop, that he's a tight MC.
He's like a good writer and he flows good, but I don't like the content.
Well, maybe that'll change, maybe it'll mature.
Yeah, I doubt it.
I don't feel like I should have to bite my tongue for anybody. I really believe in freedom of speech. I can't even stress that enough. I feel like, especially artistic expression, you know, I believe an artist should be an artist and be able to say whatever he wants to say, whether you think it's good or bad.
Coming up next, Eminem goes platinum, takes way too many drugs, and gets sued by his mom. Short Order cook, whose dubious dreams of rap stardom were clearly going nowhere. For the last year and a half, though, he's been one of the busiest men in music, performing nonstop, promoting nonstop, and generally doing whatever it took to keep walking around upright through it all.
Fame has been good to you, I imagine, right?
Yeah. Last year was a really crazy year for me, so I don't think anybody saw me not drunk. You know what I'm saying? And not on some type of substance. Fame hit me so fast, I didn't even know what I was doing.
Every time I try to tell them no, they won't let me ever let them go. I'm a sucker, all I gotta say. Drugs really got a hold of me.
A new track called Drug Ballad shows Eminem struggling to stay afloat in the midst of a hurricane of sudden fame and long-sought fortune.
I didn't know how big my record was gonna be, and I didn't know if this opportunity was ever gonna come to me again, so it was like, I was doing each and everything that I could do.
Yeah.
Any chance to be on TV, any chance to do a show and promote the album or whatever I was doing,
yeah.
You know, and, you know, barely slept. So, you know, the drugs kept me, alive. They kept me going, you know, but I've learned to pace myself better this year.
He's also learned to deal a little more effectively with some of the personal insecurities that his newfound fame tends to trigger.
I used to have this really big problem with people staring at me, you know. Like, when I was younger, and it was like, why are you staring? Like, if somebody was staring at me, they wanted to fight me, but I have to see past that and say they have a reason to, because otherwise I get edgy, like, yo, why is this person staring at me? I just can't stand to be stared at for no reason.
M's various insecurities date back to his famously painful childhood. So famous, in fact, that his mother, Debbie, is suing him for $10 million, charging defamation of character.
$10 million?
Hi, Mom.
Bitch, Mom, suing for $10 million. She must want a dollar for every pill I've been stealing.
Is this lawsuit with your mom still going on?
Yeah, it's still going on, and it really pisses me off that I can't talk about it.
But you're talking about a record, you know?
Where the fuck you
think I picked up the habit. All I had to do was go in the room and lift up a mattress.
There's a difference between artistic expression and things I say on a record and things that I say publicly that I just recently found out. So it's kind of, you know, it gets under my skin a little bit that I can't say things and make comments, you know, because I want to. Believe me, I want to. But, you know, I just keep quiet for right now because I'm paying out my ass for lawyers as it is.
Apart from M's estranged mom, there's also a growing number of other family members who've lately developed a powerful interest in their newly rich and famous relative.
For every million I make, another relative sues. Family fighting and fussing over who wants to invite me to supper. All of a sudden, I got 90-some cousins.
Nobody in my family really gave a damn about me, you know, growing up as a kid. As soon as I made it, it was like, I knew you'd make it, I knew you'd make it, or you know, remember when I, you know, I changed your diapers and that. Nobody in my family helped me get where I'm at.
The one person in his life that he does owe, M feels, is his 4-year-old daughter, Haley, and he's determined to be the father to her that he never had himself.
I just don't want to be like my father was. You know, I want to be there for every step of the way for my daughter. I want to be there for Haley's first day of school. When she starts school, I want to, you know, I want to be there for everything that my father missed out.
His presence in Haley's life may ultimately complicate it a bit, of course. Eminem is a serious star now, and his daughter is beginning to get the picture, too.
She likes Britney Spears. She likes Christina Aguilera. And when she sees those people on TV and then me on TV right with them, I think she's getting the concept. She's really smart, and she's starting to learn, you know. Like, if we're going to go to the grocery store or something, she'll say, Daddy, you got to put your hat on because otherwise you're going to have to sign autographs.
How much damage can you do with a pen? Man, I'm as f***ed up as you would have been. You would have been in my shoes. Who would have thought Slim Shady would be something that you would have bought?
She hears my music, you know, and hears the cuss words and this and that. I don't think she totally understands what my music means or anything like that, or that it's even offensive or wrong or anything. But she hears the cuss words, she knows not to repeat them. She knows, you know what I'm saying? She knows right from wrong.
She learns these things, he says, from her newly united father and mother.
Me and Kim are married now. I keep my little circle of family and friends, people that I've basically grown up with, because I feel like at this point, anybody that I meet after this only knows me for Eminem or Slim Shady. He doesn't know Marsha, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I keep those friends around, because I know that those are the people that really, they really care about me for me.
Few would have predicted a happy end to the M and Kim story after hearing the last album's horrific 97 Bonnie and Clyde.
Mama's too sleepy to hear you screaming in her ear. That's why you can't get it awake. But don't worry, Daddy made a nice bed for Mommy at the bottom of the lake.
Is that difficult after doing a record in which you're like dropping her body into the bottom of a lake?
No, it's not, because we got a really funny relationship. Our relationship is, I don't know if it's necessarily healthy. You know what I'm saying? It's a weird relationship, man.
Quit crying, bitch! Why you always make me shout at you? How could you just leave me and love him out the blue? Aw, what's the matter, Kim? Am I too loud for you?
We were, you know, seeing other people, and it upset me so bad that she was seeing somebody else that I just pictured her in my face, and me being able to scream at her like that and you know, really tell her how I felt. And I feel like, you know, if something's going on in my personal life, that's my way of venting, is writing it down and you know, getting back at people through words. When she first heard 97 Bonnie and Clyde, she was kind of like, you know, you're in la da da da. When I made the other song, the new song that's on the album, she like, I never forget this. We were both sitting in the car, and she just looked over at me, and I said, you don't have anything to say? She was like, you're crazy. You're crazy, for real, you're crazy.
Some people are gonna say, you know, you need therapy. You have a problem with women. You feel that you do it all?
No, I don't. I feel like I don't need therapy. I feel like my music is my therapy, because once I sit down and write, I get everything off my chest. You know, people might think that I walk around mad all day, and I'm not. You know what I'm saying? For the most part, I'm happy, you know? I get all my aggression out in the studio. When I leave the studio, I'm like,
Coming up next, Eminem talks trash about Jennifer Lopez, explains his Will Smith problem, and kills his producer.
I think I killed him twice, two or three times. But I killed my girl, I killed Dre, you know what I'm saying? Who am I not killing? I think I kill you on this album.
wrong with this Eminem guy, with his drugs and his weird family and his woman problem? And why does he say all those horrible things about people? Well, in some cases, according to him, they're not really meant to be as horrible as many people take them to be.
A lot of things that I say are not meant to be disses. It's meant to be me speaking my mind. If I want to diss somebody, then I'll diss them. I'll just come out and say, Will Smith.
Will Smith don't got a cuss in his rap to sell records. Well, I do, so him and you too.
He dissed the whole gender of rap. He dissed gangster rap music.
I want to say to all my fans out there, I never killed nobody in none of my records. I don't use no profanity in none of my records, and still I managed to get up here. Please.
I respect him for saying his opinion, but not everybody is as happy as Will Smith. So if he sees life, about birds and bees and wants to rap about flowers, then let him rap about birds and bees and flowers. But don't diss nobody else. And I felt like he was taking a stab at me and Dre and anybody who uses profanity on a record to express themselves. If you feel strong enough about something, then you might put a little before you say exactly what you're saying.
Are you worried about encountering face-to-face, like, I don't know, Will Smith, Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, NSYNC? What would you say to them if you were into them?
I'm actually looking forward to it.
And fans can look forward to hearing M's steamiest thoughts about the lovely Jennifer Lopez, addressed in typically brazen fashion to her boyfriend, Puffy Combs.
Because if I ever stuck into any singer in showbiz, it'd be Jennifer Lopez. And Puffy, you know this. I'm sorry, Puff, but I don't give a fuck. If this chick was my own mother, I'd still fuck with no rubber.
Are you anticipating any trouble with Puffy and the Jennifer Lopez mention on here? Like you're going to impregnate Jennifer Lopez?
It's no secret that Puffy and Jennifer are together or whatever, but at the time that I wrote that, there was just rumors of them being together. Mm-hmm. Basically, you're saying Puffy's got a beautiful woman, you know, who doesn't want to have sex with her, you know.
And how does Puffy Combs himself feel about this salacious tribute? Responding via press release, Combs said, quote, Eminem called me and explained to me his and this is hip-hop, it's entertainment, it's not personal, and so don't have a problem with it. Every man is entitled to fantasize. I myself am guilty of fantasizing about Jennifer before we started going out. In fact, I still fantasize about her. At the end of the day, it is just a record, not a reality. Whatever. It must just be hard to stay mad at this man. Eminem actually kills off his producer, Dr. Dre, in one of their new tracks, and Dre's okay with it.
Dr. Dre said, nothing, you idiots. Dr. Dre's dead. He's locked in my basement.
So when M comes to you and he has a rhyme that says, like, Dr. Dre's dead, I've got him locked in my basement, what's your response? Do you just laugh it off?
You know what? I'll just have to let Eminem be Eminem. You know what I'm saying? I can't go in and say, yo, man, you can't say this on the record, you know? Because if I was told that when I started, it probably would never be an N.W.A.
He was cool with it. He laughed, you know? And the same on this record. I think I killed him twice, two or three times in this record. But I kill my girl. I kill Dre. You know what I'm saying? Who am I not kill? I think I kill you on this album.
I think people are dissecting the music a little too much, man. Just buy it and bump it.
What I would say to people who listen to every single lyric is like, you know, stop analyzing my too in depth. You know what I'm saying? Every single word that I say doesn't necessarily mean something.
And keep an ear peeled for the non-homicidal stuff too, like Eminem's greatest track to date, a heart-wrenching song about a fan called Stan.
Dear mister, I'm too good to call and write my fans. This will be the last package I ever send your ass. Been 6 months and still no word. I don't deserve it. I know you got my last two letters. I wrote the addresses on them perfect.
Gracious, the most amazing track. How did that come together? Is that based on anything real or?
It's based on, you know, fan mail that I get. It's really weird for me to get fan mail because I still haven't grasped the whole concept. It's weird to still see myself on TV. I don't have time to write back and be fair.
But what's the shit you said about you like to cut your wrist too? I say that shit is clowning, dog. Come on, how f***ing bitch?
Basically, the dude is crazy and he thinks that I'm crazy too. Like, I'm really crazy for real in real life and he's got somebody that he can relate to.
Do you actually get letters from people like that? From, like, people?
I get letters
from sanitariums or something?
Yeah, I get letters from fans that say, you know, I can relate to what you went through. Da, 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 da. I never knew my father neither.
Some of the people Eminem targets on the new album are unlikely to be left laughing, but that's all part of the fame game, right? The good news for silly celebrities everywhere is that there may not be that many more people left for him to take aim at.
On this album, I touched on every person that I didn't like. That's my way of venting, is writing it down and you know, getting back at people through words, because I feel like, you know,
I can use words as weapons against people.
That's what I do as a...
So watch out.
Yeah, exactly.